Now, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Now, we know that early detection of breast cancer is one of the keys to fighting the disease. We're learning more about that today. We welcome in Dr. James Kakuta, Chief Medical Officer with Polymomi Medical Center. Hello, Doctor. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me.
All right, let's jump right in. What are some things that women should know that would help them in detecting breast cancer as early as possible?
There are two main ways that we detect breast cancer at an early stage. One is encouraging women to do a self-breast examination. That should occur with every woman pretty much at every age after maybe age 30. On top of that, mammograms on an annual basis starting at age 40. In addition to the mammogram, a clinical breast exam, that is a breast exam done by a healthcare professional, should also be done on an annual basis.
Okay, let's back up a little bit to the self-exam. I hear stories all the time about how people felt something in the shower while they were bathing. I mean, is that typically what women should do, is just kind of feel to see if they feel any unusual lumps?
Yeah, I think women know their bodies the best. And being always in your body, you always have complete access to your body at all times. So you can check multiple times in a given month. It's hard to make a doctor's appointment multiple times in a given month. So women know that there's a change, and I think that's an important thing.
Okay. Now, what's some of the latest technology and services available to help detect breast cancer?
Well, we have standard mammograms, and those mammograms are, I think, ubiquitously are digital mammograms, and those are done routinely across the state. On top of that, though, there are some newer technologies aimed at dealing with this problem that some women who have looked at their mammogram reports have seen, called dense breast tissue. Mm-hmm. So to combat dense breast tissue, there are a variety of different imaging technologies. One of them is tomosynthesis, and that's a 3D mammogram. Those are 15 mini mammograms done at different angles to give the radiologist a three-dimensional sense of what's going on in the breast. Okay. Breast ultrasound and breast MRI are also options for women with dense breasts.
Can you explain what dense breast means?
Yeah, so dense breast isn't anything that has to do with what it feels like when you push on there.
Okay.
A dense breast is simply an appearance of some women's breasts on a mammogram. And the analogy I have is that dense breasts look white on a mammogram. Cancers could also look white on a mammogram. Mm-hmm. So it's like looking for a polar bear in a snowstorm. There's just no contrast.
Okay.
So these new technologies are able to use that characteristic to help us see cancers at an earlier stage.
So when you go in for a regular mammogram, they can tell you whether you have dense breast and whether a more the 3D mammograms would be better suited for you? Is that how that works?
Correct. There's actually a state law that was passed about a year and a half ago that mandates every woman in her report. Not only does it say whether the mammogram was normal or not, but it also has a comment as to whether she has dense breast tissue or not.
Okay. I've done regular mammograms. I haven't done the 3D one. Is that kind of the same process?
Yeah, the machines, a tomosynthesis machine also does standard mammograms.
Okay.
But in addition, you may or may not notice that the x-ray source actually rotates over the woman as the breast is being kind of smushed for the mammogram,
okay,
taking 15 images from different angles.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, what are you guys doing this month for Breast Cancer Awareness Month?
So all four hospitals of Hawaii Pacific Health, Polymomi, Kapi'olani, Straub, and Wilcox, are lighting the buildings pink. And we're not celebrating breast cancer, but we're celebrating the Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
Mm-hmm.
It's important to detect breast cancers early, and we feel that it requires some recognition, and we want to get that awareness out into the public.
Absolutely, it really is. You know, you're celebrating the survivors, but also reminding people that it's so important to get screened. I mean, this is a beatable disease if you catch it early.
Breast cancer survival in stage one is 96%. Breast cancer survival in stage two is maybe 85%. So,
wow.
Big difference.
Now, is there anything else that you can tell us about breast cancer, what people can do perhaps to prevent it?
Breast cancer prevention is a hard thing. People have looked at a lot of different things, where it's diet or exercise, not smoking, green leafy vegetables. I think those are all important in terms of overall general health.
Mm-hmm.
And we do know that general health is an important part of beating a breast cancer. And the data isn't really good in terms of whether it prevents a breast cancer. So early mm-hmm. detection still remains the key.
Okay, doctor, thank you so much for being with us.
You're very welcome.
Again, women get screened, right? Yeah. And not just women, too. Men as well.
Men as well can get breast cancer, sure.
Absolutely.